What do you guys are? Damn, it's nice. Getting that one and I'm feeling bad about it. But yeah, you get my point. You get my point.
Lovely people, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new here, welcome. I'm Kasturi. I make weekly videos about minimalism, intentional living, slow and ethical fashion. So if you think you are interested in something like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon next to it so YouTube will notify you whenever my next video comes up, which is usually Saturdays. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 20 things that I don't buy anymore. Now this is not an instruction video or a video where I'm telling you not to buy these things. But if you're looking for some ideas on things that you can maybe live without or you want to reduce your consumption to save money, then hopefully you'll resonate with this video. I get it that everybody has a different lifestyle and everybody lives in different circumstances. So take whatever you feel is right for you for this from this video and keep whatever makes you happy. So without any further delay, let's dive right into the video. That my hair type doesn't really need hair conditioners. So I experimented like few months ago, like I think it's been 8 months, around 7-8 months that I've not put any conditioner in my hair after shampooing my hair, and it has never been so healthier. And also I'm using a baby shampoo, not like a proper shampoo. I'm using this shampoo, which is Himalaya Gentle Baby Shampoo, and it has worked wonders for me. Yeah, and if you guys want to experiment this at home, this is the time because we are not going outside anywhere, so we are not exposed. So why use so many chemicals on your hair? You can experiment with home remedies or, you know, like baby shampoos, not using conditioners and all of that. So yes. The second one is phone cases. I realized that I don't really need like a bunch of colorful phone cases when I just have one. And I'm not like a person who's going to change phone cases like thrice a month. I'm okay with a black like basic phone case and I can use it as long as it is not broken. So yeah,
that's how I function.
I love traveling, and whenever I used to visit a new city, country or a state, I used to collect those little things which used to remind me of that place, especially magnets or, you know, the small little things that you keep on your table, etc. And then I realized that once I bought them and took them home with me, they were more of a dust collector than, you know, reminding me of that place or the memories. So instead of collecting the souvenirs or especially the magnets, I now click really good pictures that can bring my memory back whenever I look at them. And also I prefer, you know, buying a few spices or, you know, a different kind of achar or something like that, so I can consume it and that can remind me of that place. I no longer buy cleaning products for dusting or cleaning glass. Instead, I make it at home. And I'll link the recipe somewhere here or in the description down below. I've made a video on DIYs and one of them is cleaning products. Next one is fast fashion. In one of my previous videos, I mentioned the impact of fast fashion on people and the environment. I'll link it on here and also in the description down below. Do watch the video and you'll realize why I myself don't consume fast fashion, even though I used to work for fast fashion brands for the longest time. I used to love fancy notebooks and those yearly planners, and I always used to think that I'm gonna write each and every day, you know, I would write my to-do list, I would write a lot of things in it. But then I realized over the years I don't even use every page of it. That hit me that I'm not even using each page. I'm wasting so much paper, which is not worth it. And also I have a notebook. It's not like I don't have a notebook. I have a notebook which I'm gonna fill each page of, and then I'm gonna move on to the next notebook. So yeah. Next one are the home decor items, you know, those small little cute knickknacks which you buy and then you keep it at a corner and forget about it. I'm kidding, I'm just talking about myself. I used to do that. I used to buy a lot of these cute little home decor products. They were just lying around. So I switched the home decor items with plants. I love plants and they spark a different kind of happiness in your house, and there is so much positivity if you have plants around inside your house. The next one is pretty obvious, which is plastic water bottles. I mentioned this in my previous DIY sustainable living video, that I carry 1.5 liter water bottle whenever I go out, so I don't have to buy those plastic bottles, and it's high time that we chuck that out of our lifestyle. So when I was in college, I had this I had this thing that I wanted to buy a lot of branded products, foundation, concealer, primer, and all of these things. I bought them and I barely used them. Like, I used them like twice or thrice a year. I don't go to salons anymore to get my hair cut. First time I cut my hair when I was in my NIFT postgraduate college, and it was super fun. I did it just for experience, but I never went back. I remember I told my friends that I cut my hair and look at that and all that, but they were like shocked and they couldn't believe that actually I cut my own hair. It's super cheap, it saves a lot of money, and why not? There's nothing to be scared of. All of these sheet masks and the fancy hair packs and face packs, I've said a no-no to them. It's been long actually, this is not something that I've picked up just now. This has been like going on since a lot of years, I don't even remember. Other than that, I make my own packs at home for hair and face, which works really well for me. I'm gonna link that video also in the description down below and somewhere here. You know, what if my umbrella breaks down or my raincoat gets torn, then what to do? So just in case, I should have another umbrella and I should have another raincoat. That is not my deal anymore. I don't do that anymore. I used to love storage units. I don't know why. Even if I didn't have any items to keep them in, I used to love those little drawers or, you know, the little boxes you can keep your stuff in. I have said no to them because, first of all, I want to reduce my stuff. I don't want to bring in more stuff and buy then a storage unit to keep them in. So yeah. Again, one more service from the salon is manicure and pedicure. I've stopped doing that, and in one of my videos I show you how I do my pedicure at home. I'm gonna link that also here and in the description down below. Next up is air fresheners. You know, the one with really nice fragrances like rose, lily, lavender, etc. I've switched them with incense sticks. They last you longer and it saves a lot of money. Them are non-biodegradable and eventually they end up in landfills. Instead, I make my own makeup wipes. I made a video on that too. I'll link in it here or in the description down below. The next one is hand wash. This is purely because I had no choice but to make my own hand wash. This was around, I guess, April that I couldn't find hand wash anywhere in the market, and I was out of it and I had the need of it because it was like that time. I had a few ingredients at home, luckily enough, and I made it, and it turned out to be really nice. So I thought, why not to make it at home instead of buying it outside, again contributing to plastic, etc. So yes, from now on I make my own hand wash. I used to love buying heels in all the colors and all the sizes, but I'm anyways 5'8 and I didn't really need it then and also now. Not to mention that they are extremely uncomfortable for me now that I don't get any use out of them, and the ones that I already have are kept there for since I think a year. So yes, no more heels. The 19th or the second last thing is things that I have not finished yet. For example, if I have a lotion at home and it is not finished yet, I'm not gonna go buy another lotion, no matter what brand is it or what new launch like range has come, because what happens is when I buy a new lotion and I already have one at home, I forget about the old one and I just focus on the new one. And I don't know if you resonate with this, but then the old one gets expired and I forget about it, and that also goes to waste, which really feels bad.
You get my point?
Sales are made for us to buy impulsively. they negate the situation of intentional buying. Anyways, if I'm buying something on sale, I'm still buying it. I'm still paying for it. And as I've heard few minimalists say that if you don't buy anything on sale, it's 100% off. And thank you so much for watching this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Share it with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next one.
Bye.